Hey guys, doing some more work on the Technics receiver that I replaced the diodes. The issue I have now is since I moved, the cat likes to camp on top of it when it's on, and it overheats. And it's got this pre-1980s brushed fan setup that when you turn it up to a certain level, the fan comes on. And it's not bad, it's a little loud, but it only comes on when it's at like extreme levels. If you remove the fan, this is the issue here, if you remove it, just by pulling the tabs on the side, there's another one right there, there we go, and then it pulls right out like that. And there's your two tabs there. Now, the problem with this is they get corroded and they don't make contact, which is a problem because what happens is, I can show you with the receiver, when it goes to go into the fan over, it just says overload on the display and shuts off. That's because it's not detecting the fan spinning. So, there's a few ways we can go about this. I'll put a dummy load on it, and it'll still think the fan's there, and we can put a brushless. This is what I really want to do, is I want to put a brushless in there. But I don't want to have the brushless on a setup where it only turns on when it's at a certain volume. I have these thermal switches. Now this one here is 135 Celsius. It's too much. This one here is 80, this one here is 50, and we can just mount that right on the heatsink itself. And the way this one works, these two here are normally closed, and when they heat up they open. Well, this one here is normally open, but then when it heats up it closes. So this would actually be great for a brushless fan, where as soon as it turns on it would turn the fan on. So. No matter what level of the volume that, when this was hot, what she does, like, it would ventilate the unit, even if the cat was sitting on them, which is an issue, so. The trick is, how do we get this, how do we get the receiver, so I don't think that the gimbal's still in. So check it, doesn't the overload here, with the fan, without you, give me overload. Once I fit failure, just says overload. So, let me toy around with it for a bit until I find something that actually works, and then we'll give it a try. Okay, one thing I did find is you can apply a dummy load to it, whether it be a resistor or a small little fan, which I will show you. And if you put that across there like that, turn it up, fan spinning. You can see, but I'm not getting an overload error. If I remove the fan, I get the overload. So it does work. Fools it. It also works with the large ones, which I will show you. So if you wanted to, you could just replace the fan with a brushless and be done with it. The problem is I don't like the way it's set up, that it only turns on when it's at the point where there's no, you know, it's like a dummy light on a car. By the time it turns on and it's being used, it's already too late, it's overheating, so, plus I own a cat. Is it on? Oh, it's not on. There it goes. So the big one won't work. But that's not the setup I want. So what I'm going to do is I will solder that in there just as a dummy load. And then I will tap into the 12 volts on that board and run this thermal switch on the heatsink. And then I will place my fan in there. I'm not sure if I want to just place it in there like that or if I want to gut this and put this fan inside there, which would actually be better. I don't know. We'll see what it takes to get this thing apart. Yeah, because you can see why these things become a problem down the road. Look at the corrosion on those pins. They blacken. And like I said, it just sits there like that. Well, basically, this is a fan there. And it just sits on those two pins. And eventually, when it gets corroded, the person turns up their amp. And it gets the overload message. They think it's the actual amp itself. When it's not, it's the actual fan. So it gives you a false reading, really. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut this out. And then I cut the fins off of this. And hopefully I can just drop it right in there. And then we'll just use the whole sleeve again. Reuse the sleeve. Okay, it's going to take a lot of chipping to get your fan to look like that. I managed to keep the ring. But I chipped the corners right off of it, so it's totally round. There's our old fan. And you should be able to just slide that sucker right in there, which it does. We don't want it too tight because it'll expand it and won't slide back in where we want it. But as you can see, it will work. Just have to finish trimming it up a bit. I don't want it too tight. So let me finish doing that and get this fan prepped. And there is our brushless mod. I'm still retaining the sort of like techniques like look. we just basically have to just slide this in here like that. And this will just drop right in. Yep. The fan is pretty tight in there. Sweet. Take a look at the back. You can see, that's what it looks like. And that's the mess you end up with. So now what we're going to do now is we're going to solder on the dumbbell load that'll sit on the board. Won't do much of anything. And then we'll find the 12 volts off that board and we will hook up our thermal diode, our thermal switch, and drill two holes, unless we can find one on here. Nope. We'll probably end up drilling a hole somewhere on here. I would like to keep it right in the middle, like right there. We'll see what we can do. I'm trying to take you along with me because I'm trying to find an active power source for the fan. And you see this chip right here, Toshiba TC9214P. It's by the Dolby test point there. And over here it says 5.6 volt STB. There's a lead on the board that reads J377 right beside that chip. And I get about 9 volts out of that, which is enough to power the fan. As you can see, the fan is running decent RPM. So we're going to run off of that. Just mark it. That way, we can hook up our thermal switch and we should be good to go. Ground it. Okay, there we go. The thermal diode or thermal switch is installed with a little bit of paste on the head to help transfer the heat to the switch. This will just get warm to the touch and this should kick in with the, I marked the pinout over here where we're going to be sealing some voltage and then we're just going to ground the fan to the chassis for the ground. I guess next to do is to put the dummy load on it. We'll just tuck that in there somewhere. That's just so we don't get an overload error. And then we'll run some heat tests, see how long it takes for it to turn on. Maybe if we are wired up. Quick test of the dummy load and turn it all the way up, which it is. No errors. And she's warming up. Quick test of the fan. It's by bridging the thermal switch. As you can see, it's working. So we'll put the lid on it and see how long it takes before it kicks over. I'm hoping it'll just turn on when it just warms up. I don't want it to overheat, so this is getting warm now, just sitting on. So let's put the lid. Okay, this is a fat cat simulator. So we're gonna leave it on and see how long it takes before the fan kicks in. Okay, a successful test. As you can hear, the fan is going. The fat cat test. Just gonna see how long it takes for it to shut off. There it goes.